Alison Frommelt is a dedicated surgical ICU nurse at Mission Hospital. Every day, she cares for her patients and their loved ones at a time in their lives when they're most vulnerable. But 5 years ago, Alison began a journey that not only changed her life, it transformed how she cares for her patients today.
I was first diagnosed when I was 33, very healthy, 33, probably in the almost the best shape of my life, felt very good. When I was diagnosed, I had no idea what the impact was going to be.
It was an aggressive form of breast cancer. At her age, there weren't a lot of options. She consulted with experts and researched everything she could find. With limited options, Alison faced some hard choices.
There were not many treatment options for someone in my situation who had not had kids, who wants to have children, and not married at the time. If I were married, it may have been different in terms of what I could have done to preserve my fertility. But that was a very big issue. So it was a matter of, do I have chemo? Do I do everything possible to preserve my own health and to reduce my risk as much as possible of recurrence? Or do I put the possibility of getting pregnant in the future as my first priority? And it wasn't in the end. But having to think about it in those terms was surreal. So I felt, you know, empowered in that decision for that reason. I think it was really important for me to feel like I was making the decision.
As she started chemotherapy, she grieved the loss of having children and even feared for her own life. Soon she faced another loss as her hair started falling out, and she had to redefine her sense of beauty.
The chemotherapy was the most, it was the dreaded part, you know, where you become the most vulnerable. I lost all my hair. I thought it was very funny. On my first day of chemo, the doctor said to me, "Alison, you're gonna lose all your hair in 3 weeks. In 3 weeks, you'll be bald. You'll have no hair." And I thought, how does he know? I might be different. It might come out in 4 weeks or 6 weeks. Maybe some of it will hang in there. I have great hair. Maybe it won't all want to go. 3 weeks exactly, nothing. And what a profound experience that was.
During her treatment, Alison formed a close bond with her own nurse. Her experience revealed just how deep and sacred the relationship is between a nurse and patient.
I was so fortunate to have a nurse who cared tremendously and was an expert at the same time. She wasn't just really good at her job in the technical sense. She was good at every bit of it. She made me feel supported, educated at the same time, empowered. As a nurse, you share these intimate experiences with people without even realizing it. And I realized it during that experience. I realized how intimate those interactions are and how important they are in another person's life.
That intimate bond opened the door for Alison to allow others to care for her and begin the healing process.
That was one of my challenges, was to allow people to be kind to me and to maybe even receive the gifts that I had given, which was just amazing. I received Oh my gosh, the most amazing gifts from the people who took care of me, my friends, my family, but to be present for that moment, for that however brief or long period of time you're able to give. That's what matters. That's what matters the most.
Battling breast cancer was a transformational experience for Alison. The compassionate care she received gave her a deeper understanding of the needs of her own patients and families.
And that's probably one of the things I take with me and hold on to the most in my nursing practice. I don't think that anyone is exceptional just by being there, by being present, by having a good education. You have to work on it every day. Every day you have to come to work with that intention of being exceptional, making a difference to somebody.
Today, Alison is celebrating the 5-year anniversary of her diagnosis. She lives each day to its fullest and is planning a wedding with her fiancé, Mark. But she will always feel a deep connection to anyone diagnosed with breast cancer.
I hope that women with breast cancer can always find beauty in themselves. And it may take a different appearance, but it's still beautiful. I hope people really hold on to that.